This is Ross McCorkle with SteelersDepot.com, kicking off a new segment that we're going to be doing, interviewing NFL draft prospects for the 2021 NFL draft. Today, we got Mr. Peyton Turner. Peyton, thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me, man.
Appreciate it. Well, first off, your alma mater, it's in the Final Four of March Madness. That's got to be exciting. Are you you've been watching that, I'm sure?
Yeah, no doubt, man. I got it on the living room every day, so I've been watching everything. Baylor's got a pretty good team, but I'm happy to watch this game Saturday.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Last year with March Madness being canceled, that was a big bummer. This year, it's definitely been nice to have it back. Even nicer for you seeing your team go that far. So, congrats on that.
Appreciate it.
So I guess our first question, going back to high school and your senior year there, you didn't quite get a full season due to a knee injury, if I'm understanding correctly.
Correct.
And for a lot of athletes, that senior year injury is super devastating to their chances of getting into a college program and progressing through their career, athletic career, however they want to do that. So tell me about kind of your path back from that, how you battled back, how you ended up at Houston.
Yeah, like you just said, senior season injuries really blow, man, especially in the whole recruiting process. Especially when you only played football for that short period of time up there. You haven't only played junior year really on the D line. It's really kind of my first year there. So, and then basketball, I'm in basketball in the summer, so I don't really go to a lot of camps and everything. So my process is like unique. I think everybody's process is unique, but it's mine especially just because of that injury. I played, I think, like two games my senior season. Funny thing is, so I had that ACL tear in that game. I think it was like a third quarter maybe. And then, I actually finished the game. I didn't find out my ACL was torn for another week. Oh, I mean, my knee hurt. My knee was hurting, but I mean, I just thought it was like a sprain or something. I was like, I'll be good. So I actually finished the game. The Texas coaching staff was actually there when it happened. And, they're kind of – I was expecting to, get an offer after that, but they're kind of waiting. The D-line coach there was – he was kind of waiting to see what the MRI said. I was like, I probably won't even get one. So didn't end up getting one until, about a week later. So I went a week with practices and everything. I found out I was on the basketball court shooting after practice, actually. I was playing a pickup game, and I felt my knee slip. I was like, yeah, I mean, that hurt pretty bad. Maybe I need to go get it looked at. So it turned out I was running around with a torn ACL for about like a week and a half. So,
wow.
But yeah, a lot of coaches, a lot of schools, didn't hear from them, didn't hear from Michigan again, didn't hear from Kent. Like a lot of schools that I was talking to, just fell off and everything. But, Houston fortunately kept recruiting me and offered me and everything. So, I was glad to stay home and play for my city.
Man, that's awesome. So you got to have a high pain tolerance then. You didn't even realize your ACL was torn. That's wild.
Yeah.
Well, great. Well, in high school, the internet at least tells me that you were roughly 220 pounds. And in college, I see that you put on quite a bit of weight pretty quickly, up to 290 at one point. Again, this is just the internet saying things. But tell me about kind of what that process was like. Like, did you go to Houston and your coach asked you, hey, we need you to put on this much weight? You played interior line at one point, if I'm not mistaken, then you kicked outside, lost a little weight. So yeah, just tell me about that process.
It was a process for sure. It was a lot of eating, a lot of workouts, a lot of early mornings, a lot of late nights after practice going and hitting another workout. But like I said, I played basketball, so I didn't really have a lot of football offseason under my belt coming out of high school. So I needed to catch up. I was just doing everything I could to get that weight back on. But yeah, I was playing on the interior. I got up to came in at 240 when I reported, but I played at 220 my senior season. Came in at 240. I needed more playing time. The coaches wanted me to get a little heavier playing on the interior. So played on the interior my first 2 years. I got up to 290 sophomore year, though, so the internet's right on that one. But I was up at 290 playing on the interior.
Wow. Yeah, so does that playing kind of or having experience playing both on the interior and as an end, has that helped you as a player kind of understanding the defense as a whole more?
Yeah, no doubt. Like, I feel for my boys on the inside for sure. It's tough inside. It's tough in the trenches, really, on the up front D line across the board. So it definitely has helped me, maybe more versatile, maybe more, welcoming that contact, me being more physical on the edge. I think that really helped my game on the edge, just knowing how to be more physical. You're only getting blocked by one guy on the edge. So it's pretty easy, especially in the run, to, you know, put my face in there and set the edge. So I think it definitely contributed to that aspect, like just my violence on the edge and everything. So it was a little bit of a learning curve, learning how to like come off the ball my junior year. Because the last time I played DN before my junior year in college was junior year, was really my junior year in high school. Because like I said, senior year, I played like two games. So just learning how to get back to, you know, coming off the ball on the edge, dipping around the corner and everything was new, but definitely helped me. I played on the interior early on in my career.
Yeah, don't have to eat up all those double teams anymore. I'm sure that was nice. Well, moving into your kind of college career then, how was your senior year of football? Obviously 2020, COVID, lockdowns, limited practice, uncertainty over whether you're even going to play the next game, whether it's going to be canceled, et cetera. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe you, did you have COVID at one point?
I did get COVID, and like you said, 2020 is crazy, man. We got so many games canceled or rescheduled, and then they ended up getting canceled again when they got rescheduled. So it was wild a year, you know, week to week, you didn't know if you're going to play. You hoped and prayed to play, but you didn't know for sure where you're going to play, which is weird in football season, you know. Nothing really like it. But, yeah, I got COVID, so I missed one game because of a calf injury. This past season, but I got COVID as well, which took me out of the next game. And then, you know, I was sitting around for 2 weeks, like, getting out of shape in quarantine. They got us locked up in a room on campus, one of the dorm rooms on campus. So it was really unique, I'd say, to say the least. But yeah, I mean, my senior season went well, for as much as I got to play. I really played about like 3.5 games because, you know, I played half of Central Florida. I played like 4 snaps of Memphis, 8 snaps of Memphis, something like that. But it was definitely unique. But, you know, I mean, you just gotta take it and go with it. So that's kind of what happened. But I was excited for my senior season. It sucks that it went the way it did. But, you know, I got to work on some stuff this past offseason that I thought I needed to work on because, you know, junior year, like I said, was really just me getting an opportunity to learn how to play on the edge again. And then senior season, you know, I got to work on it that whole off season, then go and get it my senior year. So, but yeah, I mean, it was unique for sure.
Absolutely. Well, do you have any like friends that you know that are in the NFL that have been helping you kind of prepare for this process, or like any, you know, UH alum or anything like that?
Yeah, there's a good amount of UH alum in the NFL right now. I mean, I've been keeping contact with, just asking about the process, you know. Last year, Josh Jones, year before, Emeka, Ed Oliver's there. So there's a lot of guys that we got, you know, Isaiah Johnson, you know, that got picked up and drafted and everything. So, I mean, just talking to them about the process. I know my process is a little different with COVID and everything this year, but just getting their advice and tips. And then, you know, I had the good fortune of, you know, working out at Exos up in Frisco. So there's some guys up there, Gerald McCoy, just some guys with a lot of experience up there that, you know, I get to talk to about the whole process.
For sure. So as an edge defender or as a defensive end, like, have you been talking to coaches? Is there some, like, a more natural fit for you, I guess, in your opinion, as far as 4-3 end, 3-4 edge? Have you had any conversations like that with teams?
Yeah, I mean, I've talked to, you know, I've talked to every team at this point, almost all of them, at least twice, including the Senior Bowl. So, but I mean, the feedback I've gotten is edge, you know, in an odd front, and then defensive end in the even front. So there's one team that could see me on the interior, just because they got some pretty good edges already, or they got good outside backers, I guess, because they run more of a three down. But they could see me on the interior and then on the edge when they run a 4 down. But you know, everything I've gotten is edge or defensive end, which, I mean, I'm most comfortable with, obviously, but I'm versatile too, so I have the ability to bump down, especially in passing downs and rush on the inside. So I think that's where I'd be playing at the next level.
Right. And is there like a trait that, in your own opinion, that kind of sets you apart, like maybe a go-to pass rush move that you like, or just kind of being, you said your versatility, is there something that kind of is your calling card?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, I got to work on it with my long arm, you know. I mean, I'm a big dude, long dude, and, you know, I'm pretty quick off the line. I mean, I have, like, that athleticism and that burst. So just you know, getting better. Every coach I've talked to, every, you know, outside backer, defensive end coach I've talked to is just, you know, talking about getting good at, like, two or three moves, you know. One to three moves, and just having those in your back pocket and counters off them. So I'd say long arm is probably going to be, like, some bread and butter for me at the next level, but I wouldn't just staple myself on just that thing going into the NFL.
For sure. And throughout your time in college, I'm sure you played against some pretty outstanding offensive linemen. Is there one that stands out as like the one that was just the most difficult?
I'd say like in practice, for sure, like a guy that got me better every day was Josh Jones.
Oh,
Man,
yeah.
he was great. He was athletic. He's pretty quick, good feet, good hands. So I'd say him. Shout out to him, for sure. But in game this past year, Brady Christensen was pretty good matchup. He was pretty good. Good hands, pretty strong. So I'd say he was a good matchup in this past year, especially with me being on the edge.
Yeah, looking forward to maybe getting a second crack at that against them in the NFL maybe someday. That'd be
Yes,
cool.
sir. That'd be cool.
So your pro day is, I believe, next Friday, April
Yep, April
9th.
9th.
Yeah,
Yes, sir.
so how, I guess, tell me about the preparation process for that. Are you planning on participating fully in all that?
Yeah, the plan right now is just go out there and do everything to the best of my ability. So I did have an injury in the Senior Bowl, to my foot that kept me out of the game and that last day of practice. But I mean, I've been doing pool work and stuff. I got to run for the first time really this past Friday, so that was fun. To finally get to 100%, or near 100%, and go out there and sprint. But I mean, I plan on doing everything on my pro day April 9th, so I'm excited, looking
That's
forward to it.
great. That's great. Is there a particular like drill that you've been, maybe preparing for a little more than the rest, or like, is there one that you're maybe more excited for than the rest, or anything like that?
I mean, I'm looking forward to all of them. There's not really anyone that stands out, but I mean, I'm just looking forward to getting out there in front of the coaches and showing what I got. So I'm excited
Sure.
for it.
Absolutely. Well, my last kind of question here then is, you said you spoke to every team so far, and sometimes twice on some occasions. So I take it you have spoken with the Steelers.
I have spoken to the
And
Steelers.
do you know who you spoke with there?
I don't think I'm supposed to, give
Okay,
all the info,
sure.
all the beans yet, but I mean, I've spoken to a good deal of them.
Okay. All right, man. Well, I appreciate your time. I know you've got a ton going on, and it's not going to stop. It's only going to get more intense. So appreciate your time, first of all. Good luck to you. Good luck to your family throughout this process. And yeah, we'll stay in touch. And yeah, best of luck. I look forward to seeing your name called on draft day.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it, Ross. All
All
right, you
right.
take care.